अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। लेक्चर नंबर 3, अमेजिंग साइंस बुक, ग्रेड 7, पेज नंबर 4। रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट्स ऑफ अ प्लांट। यस्टरडे वी लर्नड अबाउट द वेजिटेटिव पार्ट्स ऑफ द प्लांट। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट्स ऑफ प्लांट। इंशाल्लाह आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन वेल। द फ्लावर इज द रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट ऑफ अ प्लांट। It makes fruits and seeds from which new plants of the same color are produced. ये वो पार्ट है जिससे इसकी स्पीशीज आगे बढ़ती है। स्पीशीज ख़त्म नहीं होती है, नए ऑर्गेनिजम्स बनते हैं, पुराने मरते हैं। It contains the male and female reproductive parts. Some flowers are either male or female, depending on which part they contain. In some plants, the flowers are arranged in a group or cluster. Called and florences. I'm sure you have seen these types of flowers. These are examples of inflorescence. Let's move further. Parts of a flower. The parts of a flower are arranged in circles or whorls on the receptacle, which is flattened tip of the flower stalk or pedicle. This is a receptacle and this is pedicle, the part from which the flower is, the junction by which flower is attached to the stem. Next is the calyx, is the outmost whorl and is composed of small green leaves called sepals, which protect the bud. This is the calyx. Hey, calyx, all the sepals. This is the sepal. This is the green part. The corolla is the colored part of the flower and is the second whorl from the outside. If you have seen a rose flower, there are many whorls. The second whorl is called the corolla, and it is composed of brightly colored scented leaves called petals. This is the petal, the pink part, which protect the inner parts and also attract insects for the pollination. Insects are usually attracted by the attractive bright colors of the petals. The androecium is the male part of the flower, which forms the third whorl. It is composed of stamens. ये पूरा जो part आपको नज़र आ रहा है ये पूरा एक stamen का जो है zoomed view है, मैं आपको दिखाती हूँ। Each stamen has two parts, filamen, which is a thin stalk, and anther. This is stamen, ये इसका filament, ये जो इसका thin सी thread आपको नज़र आ रही है, और इसके ऊपर anther, which is attached with the filament and contains four pollen sacs. Pollen sacs contain pollen. The male sac cells or gametes are the pollen grains, which are produced inside the pollen sacs. The gynoecium is the female part of the flower and is composed of carpels. If you have ever seen a carpel and a hibiscus flower, this is carpel. And these are pollen grains, yellow. Yellows are the pollen grains, this is the carpel, and these are anthers. Each carpel has three parts, the ovary or the swollen basal part containing the female sac cells. This is the ovary, the oval part. The style, which is a thin stalk, and the stigma, which is this flat tip of carpel. The stigma is usually sticky and receives pollen grains during pollination, after which fruits and seeds are formed in the ovary. If the plant is the flowering and fruit plant, then it will bear the fruits, and if it does not bear fruits, then the seeds will be formed in the ovary. There may be small glands or nectaries at the base of the carpel, at the bottom of the carpel here, which produce a sweet juice called nectar, which is usually sucked by the bees and the hummingbird type birds. This attracts insects for pollination. Our next topic is variations in flower structure. Variations are due to the changes of genes and the DNA material. Therefore, there are many types of flowers. All these flowers shown in the picture are different because of their genes and DNA structures and their parenting flowers. Some types of small flowers are ray florets, disc florets, and some are spikes, like wheat spikes. Some flowers are not brightly colored. They are green and are arranged in an inflorescence called spike. They have no center nectar, like this wheat spike. Examples include wheat, maize, and grass, etc. Okay, students, here ends our lecture. I hope that you will be fine. Stay home, stay safe. Allah Hafiz.